Welcome back, students. So let's move on to the next part of this play, the proposal by Anton Chekhov. Now we were discussing here about in the last period the arguments between these two, Nathalia and Lomo. Actually, they left the main topic to one side and they start on quarreling on some other issues. And this time that there is a verbal fighting between these two on oxen meadows. So later on, Nathalia, that she gets serious when Lomo says that no, oxen meadows are mine, not yours, I have proof, all these things. So she gets serious about oxen meadows, but later on, when she refuses again and again to say that not yours, oxen meadows are ours, she says, Lomo clarifies that he is talking about those oxen meadows which are still between her birch woods and burnt marsh. I am talking about those oxen meadows. Once again he clarifies to her. Then, but later on also what she did, that she insists on calling, no, oxen meadows are ours, not yours, we have approved all these things, they are theirs. But Lomo also, that he refuses and tells nobody is ready to take behind or take back, everyone, Lomo and Nathalia. Here Lomo also refuses and tells her that his aunt's grandmother. Then Lomo tells to Nathalia, now see, this is the matter. That what is the matter? That my aunt's grandmother, my Lomo's aunt's grandmother, gave those meadows to whom? To Nathalia's father's grandfather. Clear? Father's grandfather. And this was the matter that time here. See now, you see, my aunt's grandmother, who Lomo's aunt's grandmother, give the free use of these meadows in perpetuity. Perpetuity means in continuous, to the peasants of your father's grandfather. That my aunt's grandmother has given those meadows to your father's grandfather. For what? To the peasants of your father's grandfather. Peasants means farmers. To the peasants of your father's grandfather. In return for which, my aunt's grandmother gave those meadows, but to the peasants of your father's grandfathers, but in return for which they, it means peasants, they were to make bricks for her. My aunt's grandmother, the peasants were to make bricks for her. The peasants belonging to your father's grandfather had the free use of the meadows for 40 years. For how many years had been given? That your peasants of your father's grandfather, that they had used the land without anything or freely for 40 years, that they had used only, that they were to make bricks for my aunt's grandmother, and had got into the habit, and it was with theirs, this land was with them for 40 years, so that's why they had the habit of regarding them as their own. They got the habit. Who? The peasants on your side. Lomo tells to Nathalia. When it happened there, then Nathalia once again she says, no, it isn't at all like that. Both grandfather and grandfather reckoned means thought that their land extended to burnt marsh, which means oxen meadows were ours. I don't see that there is any argument about it, there is any topic. But Lomo again says, I will show you the documents. Then Nathalia replies, no, you are simply joking or making a fun of me. What a surprise, we had the land. Then she says that, now see, look at the surprise. She sticks to her point, who? Nathalia. And then when Lomo says that I can show you the documents, I have the proof. That time Nathalia says that, now see, I think that you are making a fun of me. or you are simply joking, because we had the land for nearly 300 years. How many? Who said? Natalia says that we had this land for nearly 300 years, and you told that it is yours, not ours. I can hardly believe my own ears. These meadows aren't worth much to me. They only come to 5 decisions and are worth perhaps 300 rubles. But I can't stand unfairness. Say what you will. I can't stand unfairness. Who says? Here, Mataraya says that I can't stand unfairness. This is the matter of prestige. If you say that I can gift you, but I can't stand unfairness. Later on, Lomu says, hear me out. I implore you. Implore means I request you. Lomu says to Natalia, the peasants of your, once again he repeated the same matter. Who? Lomu here. That what happened? The peasants of your grandfather's grandfather, that they took this land from my aunt's grandmother, or my aunt's grandmother gave this land to your to the peasants of your father's grandfather for 40 years, and instead of that they were to make bricks for her, and that was only for 40 years. So what is the matter? Then Natalia says, I can't make head or tail. I can't make head or tail. Head or tail means here, I can't understand, I don't know anything else. She says, I can't make head or tail of all these abouts, aunts and grandfathers, grandfather, all these things. The meadows are ours, that's all. Who says? Natalia says. It means, see now, she insists on calling that oxen meadows are ours. It means Natalia and her father. But here Lomu also says, no, mine. Then Natalia says, ours. You can go on proving it 2 days or n. You can go and put on 15 dress jackets, but I tell you that they are ours, ours, it means ours. I don't want anything of yours, and I don't want to give anything of mine. Finally, she says, who? Natalia. In this way, both of them, both the characters, who? Natalia and Lomu, they keep on quarreling here over this matter. Actually, this matter is insignificant at that time, not having any importance, but still, due to their nature, they did not have a healthy relationship of neighbors. Both were neighbors, but still, that due to their nature, pride nature, argumentative nature, or the possessiveness, all these things, that they are not ready to understand the situation. They left the main topic behind and they start quarreling on some other issues there, both of them. So here the writer wants to say that as a neighbor, we need that healthy relationship, we need that understanding, that love, that caring that we want. But here there is lack of everything. So despite of all these things or the features, so that's why they keep on quarreling only. They keep on in verbal fighting that they are engaged. So this is the way that we have discussed, that finally that he says that he explains, clarifies the matter about the peasants, grandfather's grandfather, aunt's grandmother, all these things, but still she is not ready to accept. So this is the matter we have discussed here. Now the remaining things we will continue in the next video module. Thank you, students.